Welcome, brothers and sisters. Welcome to another video of Triple Grace. My name is Michael. I'm the founder of Triple Grace and the Righteous Path Movement Foundation. And the topic of this video is the war against the mountain. And brothers and sisters, it has all begun. Lately, there are so many news about what they call the weapon against an asteroid or meteorite. Every nation, the US, China, and most likely also Russia, are working on a program to send rockets, nuclear weapons, into the sky, into the universe, into the space above our heads to destroy incoming asteroids. This is what you see here in this image. Is the US version. This should be the weapon that will be sent against an incoming asteroid to protect the Earth. But we know from 2 Esther chapter 13 that the Antichrist will call the whole nations to fight Mount Zion when it appears over the Earth. Because he has brought in the lie with the fake aliens before that time in the second half of seals. Such weapons as they are developing right now will then be used and be sent against the mountain to destroy it before it comes to the earth, to destroy the place of Jesus. And as we see and read it in 2 Esther chapter 13, this war against the mountain will involve every nation, because a call will go out to fight against this mountain that will appear and to fight against Jesus Christ, because the Antichrist will say that Jesus will be the fake alien, because he has already introduced his demonic forces to the world. So all the nations will leave their wars against one another and will come together to fight against Mount Zion. But the Lord will most likely turn all the rockets they are sending against Mount Zion round, and they will fall against the army that are heaping, and they will all be burned to ashes, as it is written in 2 Esther chapter 13. But brothers and sisters, 10 years ago, 20 years ago, it was impossible that these things could be fulfilled. But now you see it with your own eyes. You read it in every news that these weapons are not only developed, they're already there. They will be tested so very soon, all in time for the sixth seal. The sixth seal is not now, but there's still time to test them and to prepare them and to make them ready. Wars will come when the nations will stand against one another. These wars will then stop, because the Antichrist is calling all the nations to fight against Mount Zion. 2 Esther chapter 13. Read it. Get the understanding. And you, as the harvest workers, are also mentioned in 2 Esther chapter 13, where it's written, and there will appear people at the base of Mount Zion who will have offerings in their hands. And that is you, because you have brought in the harvest. But these weapons, these nuclear weapons that will be sent against asteroids, will then be sent against Mount Zion. And the Lord will, in his power, will make it possible that they will not go to him, but they will turn around and burn the Antichrist and his armies to ashes. And so the Antichrist will be destroyed and will go into the abyss. And then, during trumpets, he will be coming forth again out of the abyss, in a kind of resurrection, a fake one, because he is part of the fake one, fake side. The first beast will be killed. The second beast out of the earth, out of the abyss, will rise up and have all the power of the first beast, exactly as it is written in the scriptures. And these weapons that you see now developing in China, in the US, and most likely in Russia also, will then be used against Mount Zion. It is all in time, all right in the right timing right now, that this weapon will be available. So that 2 Esther chapter 13 can be and will be fulfilled. And we are part of it. First, we have to bring in the harvest now, that will stand then as a multitude closed and wide at the base of Mount Zion to be raptured into paradise. Paradise will not be destroyed. The Lord will destroy the enemy. And that will be most likely the reason for his cutting off in the middle of trumpets. Most likely, that's the reason that a case that the false prophet will then bring forth against Jesus. But that is another topic. Brothers and sisters, the war against the mountain is not only possible, we see it developing right in front of our eyes with such development as this weapon here in the image. They are planned to be sent against asteroids, but they will then be used by the world's army called by the Antichrist, who is indwelled by Satan, and to be used against Jesus. Why do we have to do that? Because he has already introduced the fake aliens to the world. So if Jesus is now coming, then there is a problem. Who is now the true creator of mankind? The fake aliens introduced by the Antichrist or Jesus on Mount Zion? So he has to fight Mount Zion, and he will fight Mount Zion. Most likely with the promise of the fake aliens that they will help him. But they will not do it because they know as demonic spirits they have no power against Jesus Christ. So they will fail the Antichrist, and so he will be destroyed. Because usually you would say, who will be so crazy to fight against Mount Zion? Most likely a fake promise of the false aliens, the demonic spirits, the demons that are on earth at that time. Indwelling people. Where do we see a call for all the nations to come to fight against aliens? Oh, long way back in the past. With Ronald Reagan as a president, he sees the only reason why the whole world would come together and to join together in a world army would be when aliens would come to attack. So that is the base of all this, a pattern. It will come to pass. The weapons are developed now, right in time for the sixth seal in around 6 years' time. Until then, they have developed them perfectly. They have tested them in smaller ones, and they know what to do. And most likely this weapon that the Russians fired this week against the satellite was also a test of a similar weapon that will be used against an asteroid. So we see we have the US, China, and Russia involved in the development, and they will all come together against Mount Zion. And I'm telling you, brothers and sisters, I'm telling you, 2 Esther chapter 13 will be fulfilled. But paradise will not be destroyed. We will be raptured into paradise, and everything what is written in the scripture will come to pass. Brothers and sisters, you see it right in front of your eyes. Not only that freedom is taken away from you, and that bondage is coming, that new Egypt is coming, that the Pharaoh is rising. You see everything like that, but you also see furthermore into the future. You see, or the future past, depends on the loop. You also see the development of these weapons that will be used against Mount Zion. So all what is written, brothers and sisters, it's true. Not that I had any doubt about that, but you can see it now. You see the development, you see the rain has come in this world. You see the water events are so close. You see all is progressing to this point of the fulfillment of the sealed tribulation. Stand ready, brothers and sisters. This is not yet the time of the sixth seal, but it's the beginning of the seals. With the harvest to come in for 3.5 years or 2 to 3 years, depending how much time we have already lost and how much time will be granted during the loop. And then we have the Antichrist regime for 42 months with the attack on the mountain. And the weapons are developed right now. All is being fulfilled. Rejoice. Rejoice when you see something like this. Not because of the destruction that it can create, but rejoice because you know Mount Zion is coming and your rapture into paradise is close. Rejoice. This is another sign that the enemy is showing you. He is preparing because he knows the time much better than the churches. The churches are still sleeping. But we here at Triple Grace and the Harvest Workers are not. And we see it. And we are rejoicing because the time of Jesus is here. First 40 days and then he will return at the sixth seal with Mount Zion. All is prepared for his return with this huge mountain. You see it with your own eyes. Take it to the Lord. Become a volunteer. Join the harvest workers. This is the time to become the light that will shine in the darkness, that will walk during the seals that will bring in the harvest of the ages. You are called to a great destiny and to do greater, even greater exploits than Jesus has done. And this comes out of the mouth from Jesus himself. And you can read it in the scripture. This is another evidence that we are truly going into the sealed tribulation now. Because this preparation of these weapons, they are done for the sixth seal. Brothers and sisters, be blessed. Be blessed in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen and amen. Maranatha.